an autistic child, teachers, paraprofessionals, and abuse. Those teachers have been charged with felony abuse. Let me do it this way. Let's put up some of the pictures that we currently have of the individuals who are alleged to have committed this insane and extreme criminal conduct. This took place in Odo County, Nebraska. A high school teacher and two aides have been charged with child abuse. Nebraska City High School, you got 50-year-old Melissa Valenta, a 28-year-old teaching veteran. We do not have her picture, but she faces charges of felony child abuse, no injury, after she and two other paraprofessionals, Emily Kent on the left, 40 years of age, and Deborah Stidd on the right, 56 years of age, were allegedly caught on audio and video bullying an autistic child in the fall, right? Valenta had been Tristyn Egri's special education teacher since the sixth grade. His mother, Jennifer, said the now 17-year-old is profoundly disabled, suffers from a heart condition, and has an expected lifespan into his early 20s. He has the intellect of a 5-year-old, which is why he was enrolled in the life skills class. Egri said she had a feeling something was not right. And that feeling was bolstered by comments that former paras, as the teacher's aides are called, made about Valenta, the longtime special education life skills teacher. She said one former para told her years ago that she was lucky that Tristyn was one of Valenta's favorites because Valenta didn't treat other kids well. According to his mother, in September, Tristyn expressed not wanting to go to school because his teachers were being mean. So she decided to send him to school with a recording device in his pocket. On one day, Valenta allegedly grabbed Tristyn by the arm and pushed him in the bleachers. You know what? It says, Valenta said, you're not gonna act like a jackass every day. Do you understand me? That's a teacher with special education training, insight, and allegedly or supposedly compassion talking to an autistic child in that way. Start walking right now. This is PE. And if you're not going to play the game, then you are going to walk. The officer wrote that she could hear Valenta repeatedly saying, go. And Tristyn repeatedly saying, oh, ow, ow, go, Valenta said. Move and I won't have to do that. Tristyn could be heard saying, no, let me go. So that's torture, okay? So every day, this child was subjected to that kind of abuse. He got to a point, the child got to a point where it was time to say something. It was time to express something's wrong. The person who is in the trusted position is a complete monster. Jennifer said Valenta, Ferguson Kitt, Stidd, and a third para were all hazing him over his puppy. This is so insane. Valenta and the special education PE teacher, Chad Ferguson, started teasing Tristyn about a puppy he had long coveted and had received on his 16th birthday. They said they could send a video to his mom so she would take his puppy back. Ferguson kept talking about the puppy and what he would do with it. It's not yours, it's mine, Tristyn said, upset. Please stop it. So what do you have? You have physical torture and you literally have psychological torture by adults who are trained and educated and affixed into a position of public trust. They're doing this to an autistic child. The dodgeball incident. Are we gonna tell it all here? Valenta asked Stidd to bring me a couple of dodgeballs. A ball could be heard hitting who? Tristyn. He said, ow. Egri said Ferguson could be heard saying, whoa, that was a bad throw. Tristyn again got hit with the ball. Ow. He could be heard saying, Valenta tipped a chair that Tristyn was sitting in, causing him to fall. While he was on the floor, Valenta stepped on his index finger, causing a bruise and a scrape. Get up, Valenta said. I'm sorry, I didn't see your finger there. Even more abuse occurred. Let's put up the pictures of the teachers again, the parents. Let me tell you what these sick SOBs did. They doused the child with a mop and water dozens of times, numerous occasions. Allowed him to remain in soiled pants. Here's what one investigator had to say. Fertig concluded her investigation by saying that she thinks Melissa Valenta knowingly and intentionally caused Tristyn, a minor child in her life, skills, classroom, to be placed in a situation that endangered his physical and mental health. Jennifer is calling on school officials to allow special education parents to make unannounced visits to observe the class and cameras being installed to monitor their treatment. This is where we are now. You see, this is a real problem inside of an actual school. Are the conservatives going to, let's say, protest at the school board meeting? No. Are they going to get outraged that checks and balances were not working and children are being abused? No, because they really didn't care about the children in their initial protest. They simply utilized the children as pawns in their game. But when real children are actually being abused by adults and by the system and there's no accountability, they are silent. All right, Egri said this behavior smacked of a sort of diabolical hazing. It's sick. These kids can't advocate for themselves or fight back, she said. They're the most vulnerable kids at the school. It's a helpless feeling. I trusted all of these people to care for my child, but it's not about my feelings, she said. It's about his. He needs to be able to feel safe at a school. The mother of the child questions why a fourth woman, the third para, the wife of a school official, has not been charged. The mom also has filed a complaint against the teaching certificate of a physical education teacher, who also was not criminally charged. Let's put up these two alleged leaders. I'm calling them alleged leaders for a reason. According to the World Herald, neither Nebraska City Superintendent Mark Fitch on the left, nor High School Principal Brian Hoover on the right, have said a damn thing. They haven't even returned calls, made comments, etc. All right, well, I will tell you this. We're staying on top of this story as it develops. I believe the mother. I believe other people should have been charged. And I think there is still an ongoing cover up to mitigate some of those who are actually criminally liable. But no time ever should something like this happen without penalty, significant penalty. That's a position of public trust and they tortured people. Jackson, thoughts here?
You know, it's always people in society who get overlooked or who maybe aren't taken seriously, that receive the most torture, really, that receive the most kind of sadism. You see this also in nursing homes. You see this, you know, victims, prostitution victims, homeless victims, where the sickest things in society happen to people because people aren't necessarily looking for them. Society doesn't care about them. Or in this situation, you know, these are special needs children who can't necessarily communicate what's happening to them or understand everything that's happening to them. She knew exactly what she was doing. She found out that she could get away with this, and so she got deeper and deeper into it, more and more comfortable with it. And the school system itself, you know, that there were whispers that she really isn't nice to the kids. They never looked deep enough into it, and they're protecting their own name by not really being all over this as much as they should. But again, it really sheds light on, one, everybody is a human being. Everybody feels everything that you feel. Yep. And also, the people that you overlook, that you walk past on the sidewalks, they go through the worst. And they're targeted by the most sadistic and evil people that humanity has to offer. But this is a disgusting story.
Horrible. And I don't think the administrators wanted to dig deeper, all right?